than 1% of total venture funding in 2020, which was a record-breaking year in venture, less than 1% went to Black founders. So, number one, why would anybody want to be a Black founder? But then number two, more importantly, you know, Silicon Valley prides itself in being so disruptive and so innovative and making a better world, but yet they have a problem with diversity and inclusion in itself. So what do you think is, what's going on, Tracy?
Well, I mean, first of all, let's add Black women, who are the most educated segment in the population. We are, I think it's 0.006% of venture capital, like literally a rounding error. Yet all the research shows diversity brings higher returns. So what's going on is they don't care. I mean, they don't care. They created the system, and I don't like they and us and that kind of thing, but this, in this point, it's they. This system was created by white men. It's working really, really well for them. There's zero incentive for them to change. You know, 98.7% of all asset managers around the world are white men. And they're making money hand over foot. So I don't even talk about, like, I talk about diversity and equity. I don't use the word inclusion because I don't want to be included in their spaces. That's not my goal. My goal is we are creating spaces for us and for all. And they need to come over to our table. I don't have any desire to be at their table, you know, and I know that I'm going to look at things differently. And so I think, I mean, our whole culture right now is, you know, fear, afraid of the other, afraid of what you don't know, and lack of interest. And I just think there's a lack of interest and there's laziness. It's so much easier to look to the left and see Joe Blow, white guy, to invest in than go out where we are and find our companies to invest in. So, I mean, I come down to laziness. They don't care. There's no incentive.